Today we'll be attempting a double-sided pour. This is a platter blank. I've finished turning the outer portion of it, put a foot in a recess on the top and the bottom. So this is an attempt. Tried using heavy paper stock, like magazine. It didn't work, so I switched over to a card. Kind of a close up here. Not real happy with the colors. There's the top dried. I end up turning this away. I don't care for it. It's got a lot of texture. You can see it here. like the rim, I can return the foot and create a clean line for the paint to natural wood. Hadn't turned the bottom or the top away as at this point, and I'm trying to dab the paint on the rim just to where it doesn't run over the edge onto the other face. Somewhat successful, but not good enough for a finished piece. So in the end, I end up turning away the whole top face, this being the bottom. This is what I ended up doing to the top. I'm using Iridescent aniline dyes, and the black is Balin Solar Lux. I'm just spritzing it with isopropyl alcohol to help blend the colors. Going for kind of a mottled look here. I don't want a consistent, just straight teal. Before I go on to the acrylic paints, I just want to get it good and dry using the heat gun. And I'm going to be using just Sonja iridescent acrylics, just the one color. Consistency has got to be fairly thin. This probably would be about whole milk. The thicker you put these colors on, the less they radiate, let's just say. Thank you. This is what I ended up with. There is a little texture on the base. I can live with a little bit. I'd just soon have it completely smooth. Before I turned the bowl out, I rechucked it off in the front face and trued up the foot. Gave me a nice clean line there. And then I just turned it around and turned out the bowl portion, which gives you a nice clean line on the rim.